Dear brothers and respected elders, mothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It was announced that we will be having a question and answer session. But at the same time, on the flyer they have covered up quite a few subjects for me to discuss. And one of the topics for me to discuss was husn akhlaq and good character. So I decided that I'll spend about 10 or 15 minutes in covering up this topic of husn akhlaq and good character. And thereafter we'll go into our session of questions and answers. Almighty Allah tabarak wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran Kareem, لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِنْ أَنْفُسِهِمْ يَتْلُو عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ. In this verse, Almighty Allah tabarak wa ta'ala enumerates the mission of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his responsibilities. One of the responsibilities given to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is tazkiyah. The word tazkiyah literally means to purify. It is to purify the people from wrong aqaid and wrong beliefs. And at the same time, it's to purify people from bad character, bad thoughts, bad philosophies and bad ideologies. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came in this world to teach the people good character and good conduct. Almighty Allah tabarak wa ta'ala explains the good character of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he says, إِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. That verily you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are on good, beautiful, sublime character. When we look into the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is filled with incidents of good character and husn akhlaq. In the prime stages of Islam, or before Islam, in Makkah Mukarrama, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had a deal with a non-Muslim. The non-Muslim, he had purchased something from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he told Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to wait there. He will go home, fetch the money and pay the money to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The person went home and he forgot to come. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, keeping up to the promise, he remained in that place. And he stood there or stayed in that area for almost 2 or 3 days. The person forgot to come. On the third day, when the person by chance passed that area, he realized Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is there. And he took a promise from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to wait there. He boldly apologized to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he paid the money. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam hijrat and went away to Madinah Munawwara, the same person, he comes up to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he says that I knew the same person with whom I had a deal and you have given me a promise that you will wait at a certain place and after 3 days have paid your money. Well, are you the same person? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yes, I am the same person. That person was so affected with the husn akhlaq and the character of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and now that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the same person claiming nubuwwat and prophethood, the person was so affected with the husna akhlaq and the character of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he says, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam accepted the people with good character and husna akhlaq. One, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was seated in a masjid. One Jew, he came up to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and started claiming his money. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him that I don't have the money now. And the Jew has come before his account is signed. The Jew started becoming abusive to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Sahaba that was seated around, they started condemning and rebuking the Jew, showing him big, big eyes, rebuking him and telling him that this is our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You can't talk to him like that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam struck the Sahaba. And he told him, let the Jew talk whatever he wants to talk. Inna lisaahi bil haqqi maqala, that the person who has a claim, he also has a right to speak. Usko chodo, unko bolne do. And this was in the presence of all the Sahaba. So many Sahaba were there. The Jew then said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that if you don't pay me my money, then I will not leave you. Make arrangement for the money to be paid. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't have money. The Sahaba that were around, they didn't have money. The Jews sent by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from Zuhar till Asar, from Asar till Maghrib, Maghrib till Isha, whole night he sat beside Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to ensure that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is going to make arrangement for his debt to be paid. And nobody has money for Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's debt to be paid. After the Fajr Salah, when Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to perform the Fajr Salah, this person went out of the masjid. He comes back, there was water dripping from his face and his hands. He comes and he embraces Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he says, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sahaba shocked. A few moments ago, this person, he was the enemy of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was abusive to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is brought about a revolution in his heart that in a few moments now he is submissive to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he is bringing iman. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ne unse pucha ki kya baat hai. Chand minute pehle aap to mere dushman the, ab aap iman laye uski kya wajah hai, what is the reason? So he tells to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know who I am. I am one of the most wealthiest Jews in Madinah Munawwara. And Allah has blessed me with so much of wealth. I am in the search of truth. In the Torah, I have read the description of the final prophet and messenger. Torah ke andar mein, aakhri nabi ke awsaaf hai, maine usko padha. Aur ek muddat tak, main aapko kareeb se dekhta raha aur aapko jaanchta raha, कि क्या आपके अंदर में वो औसाफ है जो तौरात के अंदर में आखिरी नबी के बारे में फरमाया है. और खुदा की कसम जितने औसाफ तौरात के अंदर में मौजूद है मैंने आपकी जात अकदस के अंदर में उसको पाया. बट इट इज रसूलुल्लाह सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम दैट देयर इज वन क्वालिटी, द क्वालिटी ऑफ हिल्म एंड तहम्मुल, द क्वालिटी ऑफ टॉलरेंस व्हिच इज मेंशनड इन द तौरात. I could not speak in you until I don't have a personal relation or a personal dealing with you. Torah ke andar mein ek sifat thi aakhri nabi ka ke unke andar mein tahammul hoga, unke andar mein burdbari hogi. Aur maine socha ke main aapke saath koi muamla karu aur us muamla ke zariye se main aapka ilm ka, aapke tahammul ka aur aapki burdbari ka bhi imtihan lu. Aur is wajah se میرے آپ کے ساتھ یہ معاملہ کیا. خدا کے قسم یہ آخری صفت جو تورات کے اندر میں آپ کے بارے میں باقی تھی آپ کے اندر میں 100% پاتا ہوں. مجھے یقین ہے اور کوئی شبہ نہیں کہ اللہ سے آکے آپ اللہ کے رسول ہیں اور اللہ کے پیغمبر ہیں. It was this حسن اخلاق and this character of رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم that attracted the people to the religion of Islam. And you can go on and on, talking about the husn akhlaq of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, pucha gaya, then what is the most weightiest thing on the scale on the day of Qiyamah? Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam farmaya, that good character and good conduct. Hadith ke andar mein aaya hai, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam farmaya, khaliqun nas bi husni khuluqin. Logo ke saath husn akhlaq ke saath pesh aao. In one hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ne farmaya that the best among you is that person who has good character and best character. Allah ta'ala hame amal ki tawfeeq naseeb farmaye and give us tawfeeq in hidayat, inculcate within us beautiful character. Character where when we conduct ourselves with people, we are always considerate of the feelings of the next people over our own feelings. That is good character, husn akhlaq, even to show a smiling face to a person. Tabassum aur chehre ke andar mahabbat dikhane mein koi rakam kharch nahi hota hai, magar hamare biradar ka ya bhai ka dil khush ho jayega. Bhai ka dil khush hoga, Allah khush ho jaye. Allah khush ho jaye to Allah ki rehmat hamare upar aati hai. Allah amal ki taufeeq nasib farmaye. Amin. Can go on and inshallah.